just want to address a couple things here quickly before we get started. So organizationally, just want to reiterate our commitment to Deshaun Watson. He's had a great impact on this organization, a great impact on a lot of people, a great impact on this team. And we look forward to the opportunity to spend more time with him here this spring once we get started. And, you know, we have zero interest in trading the player. We have a great plan, a great vision for him and for this team and his role on our team. And we look forward to the opportunity to spend more time with him here this spring.
He is a Houston Texan, and I want him to be a Houston Texan. And the reason I'm in this position today is because I knew he's going to be a Houston Texan.
So you heard it again.
Mike Smith.
Have a change of mind?
It's worse. It's worse than I thought. This is a bad job. It's a bad job of messaging. Because, Mike, you and I know that when you have a press conference, you're always talking to somebody else. You're not necessarily talking to the people in front of you. If you're talking to the people in front of you, you're trying to reach, if they are writers, old school, if they're writers, you're trying to reach their readership. If you got a digital audience, you're trying to reach that digital audience. And sometimes you're communicating with the people in your locker room. Coaches do that all the time. In a press conference, they're trying to set the tone for the next event or the next game. In this case, right, Houston Texans have to know that they care about bringing back Deshaun Watson as their franchise quarterback. He's the only person that they have to talk to. So when they said, and we didn't show it in that clip, when David Culley says, hey, I'm not really concerned about all the outside noise, paraphrase. But anyway, basically, this is coming from the outside. These people talking about Deshaun Watson wanting to be traded, they're outside of this locker room. I'm concerned about who's here right now and who's a Houston Texan right now. It's not coming from the outside. It's coming from Deshaun Watson. So the message that the Houston Texans continue to send to Deshaun Watson, even when they're trying to get it right, is we ain't listening to you. We'll continue to play this game up front. We'll play games publicly and pretend to talk with you privately on the real, although you don't trust us to talk privately on the real, because the last time we did that, we did the opposite of what we said we were going to do, which is why you want to be traded in the first place. Bad job. Terrible PR, Houston, Texas. He's not playing for David Culley.
On Monday, do you remember on Monday when you said, wisely, and I wish y'all would listen when you said it, don't ever listen to what players say after a loss. They're emotional. Don't ever listen. Don't ever pay attention to what they're saying immediately after a loss. Okay, let me give you some of that advice as well. Don't listen to what a new head coach and a new GM say at a press conference. Like, Michael, I hear everything you're saying about the reality of the situation. Trust me. They're not talking to Deshaun Watson. Listen, as Rachel Maddow always says, watch what they do, not what they say. Whether he gets traded or not, that's not for the press conference. The press conference is for you to put on a happy face and a poker face at the same time. This is the only time I'm going to compliment the Texans, and that is for presenting a united, positive front today, because their goal in this situation should still be, as far gone as this may seem, as much as this ship has sailed, as much as Deshaun Watson could give to you-know-whats about what they're saying right now, his mind is made up. Their goal at this moment, because there are no games being played anytime soon, last I checked, their goal, and I'm looking at it from a Texans perspective, just bear with me when I say this, their goal at this moment should be to try to salvage this relationship. You don't just throw in the towel on this relationship. You try to work it out as best you can, even if all signs point to the fact that it's too far gone for this to be salvaged. Against all evidence to this point, you got to sit here and tell, in your first statement as a coach, say, I'm here because I want to be with, if they are speaking to Deshaun Watson, what David Culley is saying is that I'm here because of you, man. I'm here because I want to coach you. I want to be in a relationship with you. I want to move this organization forward with you.
I didn't tell you. I told you. And if I'm Deshaun Watson, I'd say, I didn't tell you to come here.
And that's fine. And we can have that conversation in private. But publicly, what I'm putting forth is a desire, as an organization, is a desire to not trade a top five, and that's being conservative, a top five quarterback. I have no problem with how the Texans handled their business today. Now, how business gets done moving forward, that's a separate conversation, which, of course, we'll get into.
They're playing make-believe. They're playing make-believe. And I didn't really, don't do that. I'm not saying you. I'm saying for them. Don't play. Come on, man. Come on.
I said, yeah. And you said, don't do that. I agree with you. Are playing make-believe. Yeah, I agree with you.
Yeah. I mean, it's just like, this is how they got themselves into this position in the first place. They're just a bad organization. I'm thinking about so many. That's why I paused, because there's so many layers of it, so many pieces of it that don't make sense, including David Culley. You're here because of Deshaun Watson? Did they address in this press conference? I'm not sure they did. Did they address in the press conference that Mike Florio's great report that the whole plan is to bring in David Culley for a couple of years and then turn it over to Josh McCown? So are you here because of Deshaun Watson? Or are you here because Jack Easterby wants somebody to babysit Josh McCown for a couple of years before he makes him the head coach? And then in that case, do you want to retire in 2 years? That's the agreement? You get your first shot? This is what you get. Think about this. You get your first shot at being a head coach. What you laughing at?
Mm-hmm. I'll tell you in a second. I'll tell you. I'm listening, but I'll tell you what I'm laughing at.
You get your first shot to be a head coach, and the terms, reportedly, are you coming in, you're a shelf life guy. You're in, and you're keeping it warm. There it is. You're keeping it warm for somebody else. Okay, what happens if you go 12-4 and back-to-back 12-4 and, losing a divisional round 1 year, get to the AFC Championship game the next, are you out? Man, what is that? And if you're Deshaun Watson, this charade, I'm telling you, okay, you're right. I'll meet you here, Mike. I'll say,
okay,
they weren't talking to Deshaun Watson at all. If they're talking to the fans. And they're talking to, they're trying to present a united front to anybody who cares about the Houston Texans. And they're just trying to say, hey, this is a good situation. We don't want
to. Also to any potential buyers. Also to any potential teams out there who may be interested. We are not interested in trading, quote unquote, the player. Leverage. Can't just be like, all right, yeah, we can't salvage this. So have at it. What you got?
Imagine.
Poker.
You told me to put myself in the shoes of the Houston Texans. I tried. Mm-hmm. I tried to do it. And what
they didn't fit well. They were uncomfortable.
I wanted to go back and be like, okay, let's just rewrite everything. Let's just try our approach. Nick, don't come out with the opening statement. Don't try this preemptive strike. You're not good at that. You're not good at PR because you used to work for the Patriots. We're not taking the Patriots cues on PR. They win games. They're great at winning games. They're not great at PR. That's not their strength. So we're not going to let you quarterback this thing, Nick. That's one. But two, look at it from the perspective of Watson. He's sitting there watching look at these clouds. That's why I don't want to be there in the first place. They just keep perpetuating. The things that are already in his mind, they haven't done anything to put him at ease. They haven't done anything to make him think, all right, it'll be all right. Maybe I overreacted. This thing is dead. I'm sticking with my statement, Mike.
No, it's done. It's done. He is dug in. Like I told you earlier, this is a Mexican standoff. He is not showing up anytime soon, if at all, if it comes down to it. I think they continue to underestimate just how far gone this is. However, what I was laughing at a second ago was, I was thinking, do you and I, in conversation, which movie do we quote more, Training Day or Pulp Fiction? Because as you're talking, I'm thinking to myself, you got me feeling like Jules when he in the bathroom with Vincent, and he didn't wash his hands. Be like, you watched me wash him. I watched you get him wet. And I'm like, Michael, don't put me in this position, man. Don't put me in this position to have to defend the Houston Texans. Don't put me in a position to have to find logic in the illogical. Don't make me have to sit up here and sound like I'm a Texans guy, like I'm on their payroll or anything like that. Like, no. What they said today was exactly what we expected them to say. It's exactly what they should have said. And it's exactly the posture that they should maintain until the last resort. Like, we all just got to settle in and buckle up and just know that this is going to be a long process. This is not going to be resolved overnight because, again, ain't no games being played anytime soon. It should be resolved before the draft.
There is a draft.
Yeah, exactly. The draft is the deadline.
There's a draft board.
Absolutely. But that's still a ways away. They still haven't even talked to Deshaun Watson. He doesn't want to talk to them. He ain't paying attention to them. He probably didn't even pay attention to the press conference today because he already knows what he wants. His mind's made up. That's a wrap. So what I'm saying to you.
Does he still follow them on Twitter?
Specifically for the Texans.
That's a question.
Does he still follow them on Twitter? Has he unfollowed them? I don't know. That's a great question. I don't know if he's done that yet. I prefer the rap lyric approach. Point being, for now, the Texans actually did something right, which was to suggest that we have no interest. Again, key word, no interest, no intention of trading the player. That does not mean that they won't. Now, they would have been a real case of denial on display today had Nick Caserio said, we're not trading Deshaun Watson, full stop. Had he said that, well, then I might be a little concerned about just what planet they're living on, okay? David Culley said in his rah-rah coach, he's going to be a Houston Texan. It sounded more like wishful thinking, even the way he delivered it. Because I'm here because he's going to be a Texan. Like, speak it into existence and it'll be the case. That's how I read it from him. He said, we have no interest in trading the player. Okay, if you're another team.
Zero interest.
Let me make you interested. Right. Zero interest. Okay, well, let me help you out with that. Here's our offer. Let's talk. And then Deshaun, you get with his agent. And you work it out. This will all work out. Not overnight, but it'll all work out.
I've given my opinion a couple of times on this Culley thing. It really bothers me. It bothers me to my core.
It incenses you?
I don't know if this ever. I don't know if this ever happened to me. Maybe it did happen to me, and I'm just trying to block it out. I'm just offended. And if he's not offended, I'm asking, why aren't you? And if it's not true, knock it down. I've seen some reports out there. No, hey,
can't
David Culley will be the coach.
Knock down every report.
This is pretty explosive, though. This is now the Deshaun Watson report is the most. It's the number one story, not only in the organization in Texas, but in the NFL. Number one story in the NFL. Deshaun Watson wants to be traded. But a very significant story for the Houston Texans is that their coach, great story. Everybody raves about him. Their coach is a bridge to Josh McCown. I mean, you don't have to go crazy. You don't have to, like, you know, beat your chest and stand on the table and say, oh, come on, these guys, these reporters, these media people, these hot takers out here, clickbait, you know, all this stuff. But you got to, I would say you should probably bring that up. Does that bother you at all, that report, or is par for the course what?
I mean, first of all, I didn't see the entire press conference today, so I don't know if he was asked about it or not. I can't say definitively. I don't know if you saw the whole thing. Maybe it was brought up. Maybe he did debunk it. I'm not sure. Did it bother me?
I'm not even talking about the debunk. I'm talking about the report itself, not even the debunking of it.
No, I got you. I'm just saying, you say you just got to bring that up. For all we know, he did address it today. That's all I'm saying. I'm just allowing for the possibility that he did address it. To answer your question, whether I'm bothered by the report from Mike Florio, Pro Football Talk, that David Culley is seen as a bridge to Josh McCown. Well, he's 65 years old. So he's a bridge to somebody. Eventually. Sooner or later. It depends on the length of that bridge. No, I'm just saying, I don't know how long he's been a coach.
Bill Belichick.
I'm not trying to put him out to pasture. I'm saying it's not like he's a young coach is gonna coach forever. I'm not saying that bridge has to be 2 years, 3 years. Or 5 years. It might be 10. I don't know. He's a bridge to somebody. He's on the back nine. We all are. You know, on her, like a departed. She's on her way out. We all are. Act accordingly. That's all I'm saying.
Don't be quoting that whack movie. Quoting that whack movie. Anyway, I knew I had I knew I'd get that response. It's not a whack movie. It's a whack ending. We talked about this before. Terrible ending. Great movie until the last, like, 6 or 7 minutes. Just a joke. All right. Yeah, you can figure out an ending. Who's writing the ending for this? The Houston Texans PR department writing the ending for The Departed? Awful with a capital A. No, go ahead.
I'm trying to keep from cussing more than anything. I don't know what the next words out of my mouth to be cuss words.
What?
I'm trying to keep it clean. My kids may be watching. Your kids may be watching. What was I saying? I'm sorry. Did I break your concentration?
I'm sorry. I did.
Okay. Yeah. It doesn't bother me. No, it doesn't bother me. Yeah. Honestly, it doesn't bother me because with all due respect to the report, it doesn't really matter. If the Houston Texans want to hire sooner rather than later a guy with no coaching experience, I like Josh McCown. Okay. He's a veteran, journeyman, good guy. I've known him since he was with the Cardinals, I think I first met Josh McCown. Like, good guy, been around the block. Maybe he can be a good coach someday. Mm. But if they've already identified Josh McCown as their next coach before David Culley has coached a game, that's just par for the course, quite honestly. I mean, look what we're talking about. It's kind of like, to me, disappointment or being offended is directly correlated to expectations. I don't have any greater expectations than for them to be thinking along those lines. So if that's the case, then okay, I guess what do you expect from them at this point? So if I'm David Culley and if I'm in the David Culley camp, I'm most concerned about establishing my culture, setting a tone for my franchise, and winning games forever long I'm coaching. You know, they're all temporary. That's the unfortunate nature of the business. You know, so it doesn't offend me. I saw that story. It doesn't offend me. Good luck to David Culley.
I'm going
to
tell you.
We'll see what happens. Yes.
I'm on one today. Okay, I just want to let you know. Okay, I'm there.
I kind of got that awful Departed take that you keep keep saying it like over and over, like it's going to stick. But go ahead.
Once again, I'll meet you in the middle because I'm reasonable. I'm on one.
I watched it last night. Too. If you're going to tell me to watch it again, I watched it last night.
Really? You watch
it? I watch it all the time. I watch that in Paid in Full all the time, just randomly.
Okay. All right.
But anyway, you were saying?
And you're comfortable with the ending of it? You like it? Is this perfect?
Very. I'm quite comfortable.
Yeah, quite comfortable.
We're very comfortable.
Look, Black History Month is next month. It's next week. So Black History Month, next week.
Oh, don't play the race NFL card, Michael. Don't you play the race card.
Yeah. I'll play the so-called race catch.
Okay. I'm sorry. Sometimes you got to bring levity to it. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes you got to bring some levity to it.
Why are you bringing race into this? Right. Okay. We'll get there. I'll tell you why.
Yeah.
We almost went 0-4. Like, we almost did a John Starks game 7. But he made 2 shots. But, like, 0-7?
I think it was. Yeah, something like that.
How offensive? Think about this. I'm gonna connect this. You tell me if I'm overreacting, because I know you will tell me. How offensive is it that the only Black coach hired, reportedly, I'm not saying it's true. Mm-hmm. You got to get down to the wire to find a Black coach. There are lots of qualified Black coaches. One of them is, you know, preparing for the Super Bowl again.
Yep.
But got no love from the Houston Texans and other franchises. No love.
Yeah, I want to definitely get into that later, for sure.
You almost go 0-7 with Black coaches, but the one Black coach you hire, you got term limits before he even steps in the door. It's not like, hey, we're happy to have you. Hey, congratulations. Oh, yeah, we're all on borrowed time. I know tomorrow's not promised anybody. I understand that. Mm-hmm. But before I even coach my first practice, before I go through OTAs, before I go through my first draft, I have to know I'm here for a couple of years. Furthermore, let me get something else that bothers me. Furthermore, mm-hmm. It's a bridge for Josh McCown.
Right.
Who ain't ever coached anybody.
Well, I think he's supposed to be, doesn't the report say that he's going to be quarterback coach or something like that?
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
I didn't pick my staff. I got to inherit him. So this is, you want to talk about dysfunctional situation. I might like coaching. I might be like who we'll talk about in a second. Sister Cicely Tyson, Queen Cicely, as you appropriately and poetically put her down, a vegetarian who lived to be 96 years old. Hey man, I'm 65 and I'm feeling like 55.
Yeah.
And I'm a good coach. And I have to look across at this guy who's my replacement. Furthermore.
Can I just interrupt you if you don't mind? I mean, you're speaking about this like it's gospel, dog. And Florio has a high batting average, but you're talking about it like it's a given, like it's in his contract.
Reportedly.
Worked up about it like it's ironclad.
If it's not true, I'll back off. I'm saying reportedly. Because I know what is true, Mike. I know that there's one black coach hired. So whether this is true, now I know there's one black coach, and that bothers me.
Yes. You are not overreacting. You have every right, and I agree with you.
I know I'm not overreacting.
You asked me to say, tell me if I'm overreacting. I'm sorry. I thought I didn't know that was rhetorical.
You said,
tell me if I'm overreacting. I know you will, and I'm telling you you're not.
And then I'm like, what?
Not that you need me to validate your reaction. I'm just doing what you asked me to do. I'm sorry. Yeah, but
I'm ready to jump on anybody today.
Listen.
I haven't had a lot of sleep.
You have every right to be pissed, and I share in your pissivity when it comes to the fact that, of course, the black coach gets disrespected by walking in the door with a sign pointing toward the exit for whenever Josh McCown is ready. Here's the thing, though. I don't mean to oversimplify this.
And Black History Month is only 28.
I don't mean to oversimplify this. The league did not go 0-7 so much as they went 0-1 seven times, you know, or almost 0-7. They went 0-5 five times and got two minority coaches, Robert Saleh with the Jets and David Culley with the Texans.
I don't think you can take this. There's two things. One, yes, you can take the disrespect inherent to this report. Not saying Florio is intentionally disrespecting David Culley, but the idea of it, of this situation being set up for a black coach feels disrespectful. That can be true. By the same token, I think you also have to look at it from a focus perspective, and that being that that's just the Texans. Like, the Texans can't get out of their own way. And I don't think they're doing this because I don't think they're saying, okay, let's get a black coach and let's undermine him by having his heir apparent in waiting. I think that's just the Texans Texaning. And just be, if this is true, being enamored with Josh McCown, but knowing that he's not ready to be the coach yet, which is not unprecedented in professional sports. We've heard of that before. Having a coach in waiting. That was Jason Garrett for the longest time in Dallas before he actually became the head coach, if I'm not mistaken. You know, so it's not unprecedented, but yes,
but
when you combine it with the fact.
It is dysfunctional.
Very, and that's a Texans thing. I agree with you that, of course, it's the black coach has got to deal with that BS, but that's a Texans thing. So it doesn't bother me as much because I know who we're dealing with here, but I understand how the optics look. I agree with you on the optics. I feel you on the optics, 100 grand. So just know that, you know, we're on the same page with that.
Hey, thanks for watching Brother from Another on YouTube. Make sure you hit subscribe before you leave and be sure to watch us 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern time on Peacock. Appreciate you.